2 Thessalonians 2. Now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, and by our gathering together unto him, that ye be not soon shaken in mind, or be troubled neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by letter as from us, as that the day of Christ is at hand. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he is God, sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God.
2 Thessalonians 2. Everybody, you need to watch this entire video. This is Barack Obama and the Queen and Prince Harry telegraphing the destruction of this planet and telegraphing the beast coming up out of the pit. Same as the Jaguar commercials. This is the biggest breakdown of any commercial I've ever done. I know I've said that before. It just keeps getting bigger. And that's why. Because the other commercials that I broke down, they're all telegraphing nuclear destruction. They're all telegraphing right now. But none of them had Barack Obama and the Queen and Prince Harry in them. None of them. They were just Jaguar commercials. Now we have Barack Obama, the Queen, and Prince Harry doing the exact same thing, giving the exact same message as the Jaguar commercials, exact same message as the Bud Light commercial, exact same message as the BMW commercial, and I could go on and on, but there's too many forms of media that this is coming over for me to do videos on it. It's overwhelming. So let's stick with this one. Get ready. I want you guys to listen one more time. 2 Thessalonians 2.
Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he is God, sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God.
Okay, so that's very clear. Let's look at the scripture itself. Okay, so the man of sin, I've already done plenty of videos showing exactly who this guy is. But who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God or is worshipped, so that he as God sitteth in the temple of God. We are the temple of God. Showing himself that he is God. What's the name of God, everybody? Before I continue this video, what's the name of God in the Bible? Yahweh. Yahweh is the name of God. I am that I am. Okay. I just wanted to put this on your screen. Yahweh, it means I am. Exodus 3:14. And God said unto Moses, I am that I am. Thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, I am, hath sent you unto me. So that's the name of God, I am. Here we go, guys. Get ready. By the way, you know, I want to give quick props. Eric Harless sent this to me. I know I looked in my comment section. Some other people have sent this to me, but I got it from Eric Harless, a friend of mine. And I'm going to break it down for you very quickly. This is guaranteed telegraph, nuclear destruction, and Abaddon coming up out of the pit, the resurrection of Satan. This is what this is. I'll say it again. This is guaranteed telegraphing nuclear destruction and guaranteed Abaddon, Apollyon saying he's coming up out of the pit now. And it fits in with all the Jaguar commercials. It fits in with the BMW commercial. It fits in with the Bud Light commercial. And this is Barack Obama and the Queen. I'm going to play this through for you guys one time. And then we're going to go back and I'm going to break it down, showing you how cryptic this thing is. So here we go. It says, I am Invictus Games. Okay? This is not some games for wounded warriors. This is Abaddon telegraphing his plans covertly. Here we go.
These are all the individuals from the criminal street doing their thing, running 100 meters in the West Coast. Mm-hmm. And the American man here was incredibly fast.
He was quite close, isn't he?
Message? Yeah, from Michelle. How amazing. Did you guys watch together?
Yeah.
Hey, Martin. Remember when you told us to bring it at the Invictus Games?
Careful what you wish for.
Oh, really?
Please. These are all the individuals.
Okay. I am. Okay, well, let's take it from this position that Barack Obama is the Antichrist, and that he is the host body for the incarnation of Satan. Now don't forget, Jesus was the incarnation of the Holy Spirit, impregnating Mary, and he was the host body, Yeshua HaMashiach was the host body for the Holy Spirit. Well, Barack Obama is the host body for the spirit of Apollyon, Satan. And so here we go, the devil. He is the son of perdition. He is the devil incarnate. Okay, now, what does this say right here? It says, I am, right? I am. Yahweh equals I am. And right here it says, I am. Well, these are the Invictus games right here. Well, let's go look at Invictus. The Invictus is a poem written by an English poet. And it's from the Book of Verses in the section Life and Death. There it is. Okay, it's from a section in the Book of Verses, Life and Death. Okay, so here we go. This is the text for Invictus. Out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is bloody but unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishments the scroll, I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul. Okay, well, let's take a quick look at this bottom verse, it's obviously a scoff at God, saying, you know, doesn't matter what you do to me, I'm coming back, and I am the master of my own soul. But let's look very closely at this bottom verse. Okay, so Matthew 7:13 and 7:14, enter ye at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat, because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. So the Bible says, straight is the gate, and narrow is the way. Don't forget, the Bible is the scroll, and the scroll is full of punishments that will be inflicted upon those that are non-believers, and those that are unbelievers, and those that are fearful and whoremongers and idolaters. They will all go into the pit. And that's in the scroll, the book, the Bible. Now let's look at Invictus. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishments the scroll. So he's saying it doesn't matter if the gate is straight. It doesn't matter what punishments are written in the scroll, the Bible. I am, that's the name of God, the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul. Now, I understand that this guy wrote it, this guy, William Ernest Henley. However, this is being used by Satan, using a host body, to proclaim who he is and what he's going to do. So, sit tight. So, now we've identified I am, obviously, as I am Yahweh, the name of God. Invictus Games, the Invictus poem, is a complete straight-up scoff at God. It matters not how straight the gate or how charged with punishments the scroll. I am the master of my fate. I am the master of my soul. Or I am the captain of my soul. Let's continue to watch. Now, you need to listen very carefully right here. Even if you need to put some headphones on, you need to hear this. Don't forget the Bud Light commercial. Raise a banner to right now. What about the Jaguar commercial? It's time for a new plan, and a new plan needs a new boss. That new boss would be Abaddon coming up out of the pit, posing as God. Remember, what does the 2 Thessalonians say? Who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God or that is worshipped, so that he as God sitteth in the temple of God, which is the human body. Do not you know that you are the temple of God, and the Spirit of God dwelleth in you? So we are the temple of God. So the Antichrist, the son of perdition, he will sit in the temple of God, which is the human body, showing himself that he is God. Now, he's already done this, Obama has, and I've done long videos on it, proving it over and over and over again. But this is a call to arms right now. He is laying down the gauntlet and saying, this is it. He's coming out saying, here it comes. So stay tuned. There we go. Okay, hopefully this didn't glitch. Okay, so let's continue. You need to listen very carefully to this part. Once again, it's time to raise a banner to right now. Also, it's time for a new boss. Okay, listen very carefully.
From last year, doing that thing, running 100 meters and all that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. And the American man here was incredibly fast.
He says the American is incredibly fast. And now the Queen says, oh, it's very close.
It's quite close, isn't it?
She says it's quite close. Let's listen one more time. We're going to break this down slowly. One more time, listen.
Man, it was incredibly false.
It's quite close, isn't it?
Okay, so now let's go back for a moment while they're talking about it. It's quite close. What's quite close? Well, let's look at the numbers and let's have a look at these. Okay, let's just take a look at the number 223 and the number 239. Okay, so let's look at the number 239 first, because that's what's on this guy's jersey right here. The American jersey has 239, and he just said the American's quite fast. And then the Queen says, oh, it's quite close, right? And he says incredibly fast, and she says, oh, it's quite close. Well, 239, let's go look at 239. 239 is the number, the atomic number of plutonium. Plutonium, which is used in nuclear bombs. Well, let's just go back and watch this commercial one more time. Then we're going to keep going back and forth, breaking it down. It's quite close. What's quite close?
Let's have a look.
Hey, Prince Harry, remember when you told us to bring it at the Invictus Games?
Careful what you wish for.
Boom, plutonium 239.
Oh, really? Please.
Boom, plutonium 239. Well, that's interesting. I mean, I wonder what the odds are that the numbers on those guys' jerseys actually are significant. That's impossible. It's just like the Jaguar commercials. So just keep watching. Here we go.
And the American man here was incredibly fast.
Incredibly fast.
It's quite close, isn't it?
It's quite close. Let's look at the other numbers. Okay, so we know that the number 239 equals plutonium, which is made in nuclear weapons. Boom. Boom. Well, what about Satan always turns things upside down and backwards? So let's turn that backwards. Let's look at it backwards. 932. What's the number 932? Basilia. Huh. And basilia means kingship, sovereignty, authority, rule, and kingdom. It means the rule, especially of God, in both in the world and in the hearts of men. That's what the number 932 is. Now the number 239 backwards is plutonium. And that number backwards, 239, I'm sorry, is plutonium. And 932 means the rule, especially of God, both in the world and in the hearts of men. Don't forget, all the other commercials are, it's time for a new animal. Unleash the cats. Unleash the beast. It means king, and they had a king over them. They had a king over them, Abaddon. Okay, here we go. Okay, so let's look at the number 223 that's on his chest right here, 223. And then we'll look at it backwards, okay? So 223, if we look at the number 223, it means the flame of Yah. What happens with plutonium? There's a really big flame. It's called a nuclear explosion. So 223 means the flame of Yah right there. Flame of Yah. And let's go ahead and look at it backwards and see what 223 is. Yeah, I'm sorry, I meant 223 backwards is happens just it just coincidentally. Just coincidentally it happens to be 322. The Skull and Bones Club. Well, what is 322 a reference to? Okay, 322 is a reference to Genesis 3, right here, Genesis 3. And then let's go down to verse 22. And the Lord God said, behold, man has become as one of us. That's why the other number, that's plutonium 239, backwards 932, means God, the ruler of man, the ruler, you know, the king of everything, basically. He will stand in the temple of God, claiming to be God. Okay. And there it is. 322. So backwards, both these numbers are significant. They're both significant. That is absolutely insanely impossible. especially with guys sitting there going boom. That when you say boom, the number actually 239 is plutonium, and he's saying he's incredibly fast, and then she says, oh, it's quite close. So they're saying the time is quite close. Now let's continue and watch what's going on here.
It was quite close, isn't it?
Let's pause right there. It says Wednesday, April 27th. So that was just the other day. And right here, the cell phone is at 69%. Right there. See it? 69%? Really? You mean like right side up and upside down? Really? Wow, it's going to get better. FLOTUS, First Lady of the United States. Well, right here it says now. FLOTUS now. You'll have to watch it on your own screen because I'm getting a little bit of fuzziness. So it says FLOTUS now. Now, are they saying, you know, First Lady of the United States because that's what FLOTUS means? Or is it like float the U.S. because they're about to inundate New York City with water by nukes? The number up here is 69, so there's their telltale sign. That's who they are. That's their identity. What about the number 1815? Let's have a look at that. Okay, so the number 1815 on the Queen's phone right here, see it? 1815 right there. Well, are they using military time or are they being cryptic? They're being cryptic. Every other commercial I've broken down should prove to you that this is how they communicate. That's why in the Bud Light commercial, they use the number 25 and 34. It means to pay close attention to detail, thereby gaining spiritual wisdom and understanding. So they telegraph it in everything they do. That's why on the Jaguar commercial, he said world domination starts with attention to detail. So let's do what they say. Let's pay attention to detail. 1815. What does 1815 mean? Let's look it up. He's always playing God, right? So Satan's always trying to play God, mimic God. So 1815, let's look what it means. It means completely out of, completely out from, properly rising up to experience the full impact of resurrection. It means a rising up and out resurrection. There it is. 1815. Rising up and out resurrection. Yeah, this is probably just one crazy coincidence. Not. This is the devil using Barack Hussein Obama, lightning from heaven, as a host body to telegraph his plans. And he's coming up out of the pit as king, 239 and 932, king to take over the hearts of men. It's perfect. These guys know what they're doing. These guys know what they're doing. But look at the Lord God exposing their plans, using an adult like myself to expose their plans, who had a vision company called Vampires. And we had it upside down. I mean, there's no way. We had our logo was an upside down pyramid, a V with fangs. I forgot to show this in one of the videos. Someone asked me to show it. There it is. There's our t-shirts. Vlad Eyewear. It's a V with fangs. And our logo is come out of the darkness and into the light with Vlad Eyewear, vampire sunglasses. That's why I was predestined to do what I'm doing. Okay, pay attention. 1815. Okay, that's who's making the call. 1815, that's who's calling. And it's a rising up out of the pit. I'm sorry, let me find it. Here it is. Exonostasis, a resurrection, a rising up and out resurrection. See, that's why they always destroy the temple on 9/11, The reason it's always done on 9/11 is because they're telegraphing Revelation 9/11. So here's what they're telegraphing. Okay, see Revelation 9 right there? Revelation 9. And let's go down to verse 11. What did 239 backwards mean? 932? It means king over them. Looky there, and they had a king over them, which is the angel of the bottomless pit, whose name in Hebrew tongue is Abaddon, but in Greek tongue hath the name Apollyon. So this is exactly what I told you. This is Satan telling you he's coming up out of the pit. He is the king that, you know, remember 932? It says king in the, of, over the hearts of men. There it is. 9/11. That's why they always destroy the temple on the 9th of Av. Okay, so also, you know, look very closely on your own computer. Right here, the number is 69. 69% battery. Give me a break. That's 6 and 9. It's the key to the kingdom of heaven. They know the right side up, upside down paradigm. Also, over here, there's only two bars left. Or there's two bars. I think it's very significant because of the other commercials, how all the timing is like 2 minutes till 12. And unfortunately, I haven't broken down the new Jaguar commercial with Stephen Hawking because it's the same exact thing. The same exact thing. But this takes precedence over a Jaguar commercial. By the way, this is being sponsored by Jaguar. So let's watch some more. Okay, you can see clearly now. Look, it's not moving. Look, see 69? There it is. See it right there. FLOTUS. Is that like First Lady of the United States, or is it Float the U.S. Now? Which one is it? Well, I showed you the arch with the water coming through it in New York. That's in the United States. And everything's going to float when it happens. Whatever floats will float. So let's keep watching.
Did you look all together?
Yes.
Let's have a look.
Hey, Prince Harry, remember when you told us to bring it at the Invictus Games?
Careful what you wish for.
Did you hear that? Careful what you wish for. Now here's Obama. What's over his shoulder? I am. Look. Careful what you wish for. Look what's right over his shoulder. The Invictus Games. Look, Invictus. What's Invictus? Scoffing at God. I am. He's saying he's God. Sitting in the temple of God, claiming to be God. Careful what you wish for. And so now he's saying bring it. Okay, watch. Here we go. One more time.
Yes.
Hey, Prince Harry, remember when you told us to bring it at the Invictus Games?
Careful what you wish for.
Boom. Wow, that's funny. The guy that's running has a number for plutonium on his chest. The number for plutonium on his chest. I mean, you can't make this stuff up. And the number for plutonium backwards is king and ruler. Oh, wow.
Oh, really?
Boom, really?
Please.
Boom.
Now, let me show you a couple more things that go with this. During that commercial, while this guy's going boom, look what this guy's doing. Sticking out his tongue. That's Isaiah 57. And I'll show you. Okay, so here you go. The guy's sticking out his tongue. I'll show it to you again right here. There's the guy sticking out his tongue right here while this guy's going boom. They're making fun of the sheep because they know they're going to kill him. So let me show you what that translates to real quick. Isaiah 57, here we go. But draw near hither, you sons of the sorceress and the seed of the adulterer and the whore. Against whom do you sport yourselves? It means making fun of. Who are you making fun of? Against whom do you make a wide mouth and draw out your tongue? Let's see. There you go. There's a wide mouth and drawing out your tongue. Let's see who they are. Are you not the children of transgression and a seed of falsehood? That's what the Bible says. I've known this for a long time because I had a guy named Alex winking his eye at me, pointing his finger and sticking out his tongue. And I told Chris, the manager of Starbucks, that kid's going to draw a picture of me with the dead sheep on my face. And I was right. So I can see through this. I have the ability to see through it. It's called the gift of the discerning of spirits. And you're looking at it. This is absolutely going to happen. Let's take a look at the Invictus Games right here. It is, I'll show you, it's sponsored by Jaguar. That's who's been doing all the commercials. Right there, Jaguar, Land Rover. Invictus, I am the name of God. There it is. And it says, Invictus, and it says, I am the master of my fate. And that's Satan saying, God, you can't do anything. He's saying he's coming out of the pit. He's saying he's unstoppable. That's what he's saying. He doesn't know that God's got him beat in the end. Watch this. You see this I am? See the stuff launching everywhere like, you know, fireworks? Well, let me show you what this says. Let the countdown begin. Let the countdown begin. Oh, you mean like on the Jaguar commercial? Release the cats, like on Keep Your Eyes on Gigi Hadid, Gabrielle, God is my strength, Garden of Iron, that one, Garden of Iron, the last kingdom shall be the iron mixed with the miry clay. You see what I mean? It all fits together like a glove. 932 means a king over them and a king over the hearts of men. Yeah, this is not, this is perfect in their telegraph. They know exactly what they're doing. Exactly. And that's how they convey the message. So we have a countdown that's beginning. Gigi Hadid, remember which car is Gigi in? Which one is she in? Because you can't tell anymore. You don't know. You can't see your enemy. Your enemy is concealed. With human skin that looks human, but it is turned into something else. The human temple has been destroyed. That's why I'm bearing witness to the destruction of the temple. And when Gigi Hadid gets out of the car, it says 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, or when the cars pull up, it says 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let the countdown begin. Now, let's look at something very interesting about the dates for these games. By the way, they're in Orlando. The word Orlando means famous throughout the land. That's what Orlando means. I am famous throughout the land. Everything's done with intent. World domination starts with attention to detail. And that's what the Lord showed me. Just pay attention to everything they do. Be wise as a serpent, but gentle as a dove. Okay, the games start on the 8th. On May 8th, and from the Church of England, May 8th, with the occult, you know, those who worship Satan, May 8th is a pretty big day. It is the feast of Saint Michael. It's to remember that's when Lucifer was thrown out of heaven. That's May 8th. And it is also recognized by the Church of England as the feast of Saint Michael, celebrating the day when Lucifer was thrown out of heaven. That's odd that I Am Invictus Games starts on May 8th. Think about it. The games start on May 8th, and God, who is I Am, threw Lucifer out of heaven, and they celebrate that day on May 8th, and it happens to be the day of the Invictus Games. I am the captain of my soul. Wow. Oh, wow. That's crazy. That's mind-boggling. Let me show you what else. Let me show you what else is during that time. In the Julian calendar, the 3 days of the feast were 9, 11, and the 13th of May. This is Lemuria, was the feast in the religion of ancient Rome, during which the Romans performed the rites to exorcise the malevolent and fearful ghosts of the dead from their homes. It is also like the Day of the Dead. The origination of the myth and this ancient festival, according to Ovid, who derives Lemuria from the supposed Remuria, was that it had been instituted by Romulus to appease the spirit of Remus. Wow, there's those twins again. Romulus and Remus. Remember when we were doing the arches? How the god Mars, when we were doing the breakdown of the commercial of the Jaguar, the seat of Mars. Mars raped the virgin and produced Romulus and Remus, which started Rome. Wow. This is all connected. So now, let's go back and watch the commercial one more time after I've shown you what everything is. Looks like it's coming very quickly. Just like the Bud Light commercial, raise a banner to right now. Just like the Jaguar commercial, it's time. And he's holding the hourglass, feeding it to the leopard. Gigi Hadid, she gets out of the car, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And guys, I'm telling you, I could do many, many other commercials that are advertising the identical agenda. Identical. But this one's most important.
These are all the individuals from last year doing their thing, running 100 meters and all that sort of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And the American man here was incredibly fast.
Incredibly fast.
It was quite close, isn't it?
Quite close.
Message? No, from Michelle. Very amazing.
Have
you guys watched it together?
Yes.
Let's have a look.
Hey, Prince Harry. Remember when you told us to bring it at the Invictus Games?
Careful what you wish for.
Boom.
Oh, really? Please.
Boom. These are all the individuals.
Okay, that should do it. Just go look it all up yourself if you don't believe me. Just go look everything up yourself. Go find it. This is coming. Now you've got Obama and the Queen, the royal family. Royal from what? Royal from Satan. Satan always gives the positions on this planet to who he wants. You know, of course, God deposes kings and sets up kings. God's in ultimate control, but Satan really thinks he is. That's what's so amazing. This is all about to end, people. It's coming. Be in Christ. Be found in Christ. And just be at peace, okay? God bless.